Ciao friends! In this video, I want to introduce the subtle concept of ambiguity in a data model. Ambiguity is bad, and we will see that in action. In order to understand ambiguity, we will start from a simple model and try to solve a slight issue in the model. We want to sync two slices which are not kept in sync by default. To do that, we will need to use a bidirectional relationship, but as you are going to see, this breaks the model. Just enabling bidirectional cross-filter on one relationship creates the model as an ambiguous one, and at that point, the numbers computed by my model will be unpredictable. Later, we will see how to solve the same issue without relying on bidirectional cross-filter. It's not that bidirectional cross-filter is the villain, it's not bad by itself. But it's a very powerful feature, and you need to use it only if you really, really need it. If you can live with just regular unidirectional relationships, then your model will be much, much better. So let's start by looking at the model, look at the problem, and then we will solve it in a couple of ways. The wrong one first and the correct one later. Let's get started. The model you see on the screen is just a regular model. We have a customer. Sales, so customer buy products, they buy individual products in given date, and I have two tables containing numbers. I have sales, and I also have purchases. Purchases is linked to product and to date, but it is not linked to customer, because, of course, I don't have any relationship between customer and purchases. This model works just fine, and there is nothing wrong with it. I can create a report that slices by brand, by year, and I have both the value of purchase and the value of sales. Everything is working just fine, except for one small issue. If we look at the next report, here I have two slicers. One is slicing the customer, the other one is slicing the color, and I have a report that shows by date the amount bought by different customers. Where is my issue? The thing is, if I filter the customer, you see that the slicer does not show only the colors bought by the customer. The report shows only two sales made by Amanda, for example, but I don't have a visual indication of which colors she bought. Well, I can try. I can click on Azure, it's not black, it's not blue, brown, gold, green. I can try them all in order to find the right color, but it's really bad. What I would like to obtain is a different behavior. What I would like to see is a filter on the customer that automatically filters also the slicer for the color. So I want to keep the two slicers in sync. But this is not happening. Let's understand why. The reason why it is not happening is because a filter that starts from customer reaches sales through this first relationship. So customer filter sales. But then sales will not filter product. So a filter on customer does not reach sales. It stops at sales. Therefore, because a color is in the product table and customer is in the customer table, the two tables are not linked through a relationship. I can solve the problem just by enabling one filter as bidirectional. Because if I make this relationship bidirectional, then customer will filter sales, and then sales will in turn filter product. Let's give it a try. I can double-click on this relationship and make it bidirectional. In the cross-filter direction, I choose both. Click on OK. And now this relationship became bidirectional, meaning that a filter from customer will go to sales, and then from sales, it will go to product. Let's see if it improved. If I now go to my report, you see that a filter on Amanda actually shows only the three colors that Amanda bought, gray, silver, and white. And if I change my filter, of course, the color is being filtered accordingly. So, problem solved? No. Just by creating this bidirectional cross-filter relationship, I transform the model into an ambiguous one. And finding ambiguity in this model requires some attention. So let's see that together. Let's go back to the model and let's see where ambiguity comes from. We need to find two tables which are linked through multiple paths. So we need to analyze all the relationships. Let's start from customer. Well, customer is actually filtering sales. So customer filter sales because it's linked through this relationship. Then sales filters product because we have this relationship which we made bidirectional. Finally, product filters purchases. So customer can reach sales, product, and customer, and purchases, sorry. And everything is working just fine, this path. Let's focus on date now. Well, date can filter sales and it can filter purchases. There is one path that goes from date to purchases, which is stride. But there is actually another path that links date and purchases, which, despite being longer, is still totally valid. Because from date, I can reach sales, and then from sales, I can go to product, and finally from product, I can go to purchases. So you see that we have two different paths, the yellow one and the red one, that link date with purchases. So a filter starting from date can reach purchases in two different ways. That is why the model is ambiguous. Nevertheless, the engine does not consider it ambiguous. And the reason is the yellow path is shorter and straight, whereas the red path is much longer and much harder to traverse. So why should the engine use the red path when it has the option of using the yellow one, which looks much better? So the model is not considered ambiguous. Yet, ambiguity is there. And let's see how we can create a report that actually shows that ambiguity appears. Imagine that we create a report, let's go back to blue, that slices by continent and by year. So I'm slicing by continent and by year, and I compute values coming from the purchase table. A filter from customer will reach purchases, and that is fine. But what about a filter on date? Let me clear everything and we start again. So we compute from purchases and we are slicing by country, region, and by year. Now, date filters purchases, and that is fine. So we will use for sure this relationship. And then customer filters sales, customer continent filters sales, then product, then purchases. So we are using this path and we are using this path. So far, so good. But you need to take into account that when the filter is moved from customer to purchases, it traverses sales. So customer actually filters sales, then sales filters product, and product filters purchases. So only a subset of sales will be used in order to apply the filter. Sales is not only filtered by customer. Sales is also filtered by date. So, will the engine use the subset of sales filtered by both date and customer to filter purchase, or will it use only the relationship going from customer and sales and ignore this relationship? So, the real question is this relationship being used at all or not? It's an important question because the numbers will be different. So in order to understand the problem, what I did is create two measures. One measure slices, computes the sum of purchases. So we compute values from purchases, and I just compute the sum of purchases, slicing by year and by continent. A second measure removes this relationship. By killing this relationship, we force the engine to use this path. But then I created another measure that kills this relationship, so to force to use this path. And we have three different measures. What we would like to see is that two of these three measures are actually the same number. So we understand which of the two paths the engine decided to use. And that's exactly what I did in this report. Let's go back to Power BI. And I created this report where I show these measures. Purchase no date purchases, that kills the relationship between date and purchases. And purchase no date sales, that kills the relationship between date and sales. The interesting thing to note is that all these numbers are different. The standard model shows some values, When date does not filter purchases, the numbers are different. And when date does not filter sales, the numbers are different again. Why did it happen? Well, what happened is that the engine used both relationship. When it moved the filter from customer to sales, let me go back and clear everything. When it moved the filter from customer, it moved the filter using sales and date. They both filter sales, and then the filter went to purchases. But at the same time, in the standard model, the engine also uses this relationship. So the filter from date to purchase is actually used following both paths in the same formula. This is what happens when you have an ambiguous model. An ambiguous model produces numbers which are basically unpredictable. It's quite impossible to understand from where the number comes from. And the real question for you is, would you ever go in production with a model that contains ambiguity? Well, the quick answer is no. There is no reason to build a report like this and give it to your users, because they will be able to compute nearly whatever number they like, but all those numbers, they will be impossible to understand. So what we did wrong was using a powerful tool like bidirectional crossfilter to solve actually a simple problem, keeping two slicers in sync. Bidirectional crossfilter is a powerful feature that you use it only when you really, really need it. And this was not the case. We could have solved the problem of syncing the slicer using different tools in a simpler way without relying on such a powerful feature. Let's see that together. Let's go back to our Amanda sales where we have the two slicers, and that's actually Amanda sales. So let's go back to Amanda. We want to obtain the same effect of keeping the slicer in sync without relying on bidirectional crossfilter. So we go back to the model and we disable this bidire. Now I still have the problem. The color is not being sliced by the customer. But what I want to solve is keeping two slicers in sync, not changing the model. If I want to keep the slicer in sync, all what I need to do is select the slicer, take the sales measure, expand the filter, and add a new filter on the visual that says I'm interested only in rows where the sales amount is not a blank. Once I did it, I only need to apply the filter, and look what happens. Now the two slicers are kept in sync. If I click on Aaron, the slicer only shows colors that Aaron bought. If I click on Amanda, it shows only the colors that Amanda bought. And my model is still using a regular unidirectional crossfilter relationship. By using the right tool, I obtain my goal without breaking the model. Whenever you are tempted to use bidirectional crossfilter to only keep in sync a couple of slicers, well, think again. Come back to this video and look at it again, because it's very likely that you are creating ambiguity in your model for the only purpose of keeping two slicers nicely synced. Use the right tool to obtain your goal, because an ambiguous model is quite never nice to have. Enjoy, DAX.